Hi everyone. Today we are going to look at a new tool called Google Jamboard for online collaborative activity. So even I started using this Jamboard in my teaching learning practices. It works well in order to conduct learning activities. Let us see the exploration how to work with Google Jamboard. So we need to go to Google Drive. ac.in, edu.in or gmail.com, any of the Gmail ID we can go. We need to click new button. We need to go to more. After clicking more button, we need to go for Google Jamboard. This is one of the collaborative whiteboard platform. We need to click Google Jamboard. It's getting loaded. That's all. We reached Google Jamboard. So after reaching here, what percentage we want to zoom this? You will understand much better. See, if we click background, plain white background, dotted pattern, then ruled pattern, then grid pattern, blue pattern, black color, dark background. So this is the background. So if I apply blue, this will become the background. If I apply this gray pattern, this is the gray pattern. If I apply this grid pattern, blue grid pattern, this will come. Then this is ruled pattern. This is dotted pattern. Whichever the pattern we like, we can use. I like to use this one. So I'm using this. Then we can go for percentage. So 100%. It will be good enough for students when they are more in number while taking part in this Google Jamboard. We can connect this Google Jamboard with the QR code as well, but that let us see in the next subsequent videos. This is a Google Jamboard. Ready now. Let us see one by one. The very first tool, pen tool. So this pen has six colors, including white color, six colors. First one is pen, second one is marker, next one is highlighter, last one is brush. So let me take pen and dip this red color. I can write hi. So this is for annotation. Hi everyone. Hello. Or any kind of drawing. Hello. So you can write. Or we can try drawing free drawings, whichever are not available. Here we do have shapes. Without that, if we want to do anything related to drawing, we can do comfortably with this drawings. So there are four categories. So like this, we can start explaining. So this is the very core purpose of this pen, writing and drawing. We can even use mathematical teaching also. We can try writing dx divided by dy x square y. So we can start solving this equation. It permits us to write a mathematical equation or chemistry equations, anything we can do. So this is the first step. Then when we go for next tool, marker, it is useful for marking. Then it will become little more thicker than this. If we look at hello, so this hello and this hello becomes little bit difference. That is a pen width, thickness only matters, nothing more. The next one is highlighter. This is useful for highlighting certain thing. While explaining, we can highlight that portion. So for highlighter also, we can do any color. With any color, we can highlight. Dx, dy, this is the point I'm focusing. So these are all the points we can use it and explain. Next, we can go for last one, brush. Brush is for this kind of shade we can create. So now, again, I can change the color. Let me go for blue color. So this is the brush painting. We can do brush this particular area. We can brush with different shades and colors. So this is the core purpose of this pen tool. Ready now. Next, select tool. Select tool is to move different elements. Since it is a drawing, we can't move. I will show a little bit later. Then how to clear this one? We can clear with clear frame, complete clear frame. We can use this for eraser. We can go with sticky note, text, eraser. This is the eraser. We can go for particular element to be cleaned. So this is the role of eraser. So the Second one, pin, second one. Next is select. So since it is drawing, we cannot select and move the element any other part. Completely, if you want to clean this board or background, we can use clear frame. Clear frame will clear complete. If you want to erase particular element, we need to use this erase. That's all, very simple. Then sticky note. So types of parsers. So through sticky note only, I have conducted activity. I can show, I ask them their roll number, then subsequently their answer here. The question also I started posting through this sticky note. I'll show that board as well. So here, what is the use of CFG? Context free grammar. This is a question. I'll keep posting. So the sticky notes creation also has six color. None is white color. So six colors. Right now it is availing this many colors. I hope so they may increase. So what is the use of CFG? I'll keep question here. I would like to invite students to take part in answering to this question with the sticky note. Their answers would come here. We can rearrange. For arranging only this select. See, this select I can do. Why I prefer Jamboard is, in the chat window, if students tend to give answer, sometimes few students, they may tend to give wrong answer. By the time, we may not be able to correct their answer. That will be wrong only. So here, imagine this is the contribution of students' answer. I can edit, I can correct it. Then I can inform to them. This is how we need to write. This is not the way to write. That is the advantage. I admire Jamboard because of that one added advantage. Any student's sticky note, we can, because we are the owner of this Jamboard, we have the privilege to edit any student's contribution and we can paraphrase. This sticky note, we can reduce also. See, flexible. We can reduce, we can increase. We can create a focus while explaining. Then next is image. We can bring images to this sticky note. I'm having one of the three-dimensional image, one of the product design. So that I have brought here. So this image, again, this is one of the product design image. So I can bring, I can teach related to this. We can treat it as a teaching tool or we can treat it as a learning activity tool. So this one also we need to use select, then we can rearrange element. What is CFG? We can rearrange. We can resize any element which we have brought to the Jamboard. We can resize this image as well. We can resize. This is another advantage. Next, let us go to drawing tool. When we click this one small dot available adjacent to that circle, we click, it will show all the types of shapes. So whichever the shape we would like to draw and annotate and explain, we can draw. It won't allow to write text, only drawing. For the text, we need to use the second one, text. Freely also we can use text. So this is bottom-up parser, like this, we can write. Then we can select this element also, this text element also possible to move. Next, the same text I can click here on the image. Types of bottom-up parsers. So I can type and I can annotate. Even this also we can rearrange. Then text also, it's flexible. So next, this text color, not possible I guess. So yeah, it is there. See here, text color. Again, this is basically, now it has six colors. The same, the text, the moment we bring, it is possible to change. Alignment, then the title case, subtitle, display. So this too large, so the title case. Next is subtitle. Next is normal. So it fit into this shape. Then all together, this shape can be moved any part of the window. Similarly, the text also we need to move. So this is the last. Next is laser point. Where I am explaining, I can concentrate, look at this portion. We can give the, drag the attention of the learner. So this is for dragging the attention of the learner, this laser point. What point I am talking? So look at here, concentrate here. Something like that we can annotate. So this is a laser point. These are all the basic features available right now. Then next, undo, redo. then how we can make our students to take part in this. Let us see that portion. If we look at on the top of this, we have the option called download as a PDF, save frame as image, remove, make a copy. These are all the possibilities available. Hope so these are all possible for you to understand. First, we need to title the jam. Demo Jamboard. So I'm giving Demo Jamboard. Okay. Then this titling is ready. Now, triple dot is useful for renaming. Again, to rename, download as a PDF, save frame as image, remove, make a copy. This copy will go and store in the Google Drive. The corresponding mail ID, Google Drive will get stored. So that the moment we click this remove button, it will be deleted. Make a copy is to take a copy. Next, how to share this Google Jamboard, inviting students. Let us see the last part. Now we are focusing on the portion called inviting students for the learning activity. I will upload the learning activity also in the YouTube channel. You can keep watching. So this is the topic we are going to discuss. Click the share button. After clicking share, click the get link. Click this get link. Restricted to which, anyone with the link are restricted. These all you can choose. Anyone with the link. Whomever I am giving link, they can. This is the first step. Anyone with the link. Next, viewer to editor. This is important. Editing option, if we provide, only students can take part. Done. Now next step is click again this share button. Share button. Copy link. After doing, we can do this copy link. Now I am going to click text. After this, I'm pasting. This is the link we may need to share in the chat window, or we can share earlier also before coming to the class, just before coming to the class, so that students can take part. So this is the URL generated for this Jamboard. Whomever get to know this URL can take part in this Jamboard operation. Open a Jamboard, existing Jamboard. If at all we have anything, we can open. I'm trying to find the existing Jamboard. If not, I'll open here from the Google Drive. We can open learning activity. I did not available. Recent, yeah, demo Jamboard. Yeah, this one, learning activity. This is what the Jamboard I used for the learning activity with students. So the moment the question is given, they will be giving the answer along with their roll number so that I can make a note of it, who is contributor. Then subsequently, the teacher can annotate, teacher can edit, and the teacher can give the right answer. Then we can rearrange, we can group them based on the contribution to the questions. So this is how this Jamboard is helpful. Hope so you would be getting benefited with this Jamboard during this lockdown situation. Please do share and comment to the video, and I request you to subscribe the channel. Thank you for watching.